Hi again. In this video, I'm going to show you how to model this roof for the floor plan we made in the previous parts. This is the process. First, I draw the roof plan. Then, I draw the elevation of the main section to after extrude it. Then, the same for the small part. And finally, place the roof above the house. So, in order to be easier, I am going to change my view, which says custom now, and I change to this one that says top, and it's going to be much easier to draw. To draw the roof plan, I'm going to use the command polyline. So I will type PL and press enter. Now I click to insert the first point, for example here. For the first line, I'm going to type 7100. Then the next is this vertical one, which is 5220. Next is a horizontal, which is 1000. After 3320. And for the next one, I don't know its dimension, but if I have the icons Object Snap and Polar Tracking turned on, I can hover the endpoint in this side, and when I drag it up, and I know that the intersection of these dashed green lines is going to be the next point. And for the last line, I can simply type CL to close the polyline. Then, after finishing the base of the roof, I can proceed to model it. And I will start drawing this section, which is located at the front side. In order to work in 2D, I'm going to change my view to the front side. I click in this icon, and now front. So, here you have now the front view. And to be easier, I will draw the elevation of the roof outside of the plan, and after I will move it there. I will start drawing the horizontal line, which measures 7100, and press enter. Then I can continue with the small vertical line here. I type 50 and press enter. Then I press escape. I go to the other side and I do the same. I type L to reactivate the command line again. I click there and I type 50. So, for the diagonal line, I don't know its dimension, but I know that it makes an angle of 40 degrees with the horizontal line. I hit enter to reactivate the previous command, which is line. I click in the highest part of the small line. Then I drag it to a place after the middle of the horizontal line, more or less here. Then I press tab to insert the angle that I need. I am going to type 40 and press enter. After, I can hit escape. And now the same for the other side. I activate again line, I click in that point, I place the line over the other to intersect it, but this time the angle has to be different. As the angle counts from the left to the right, as you can see in the example there, I have to type 140, because it's 180 minus 40. As these two sections, I don't need them, I'm going to cut them out. I'm going to use the command trim. I select both diagonal lines. Remember that when we select from the right to the left, everything that is covered with the selection area will be selected. I press enter. And now I can click in the sections I want to delete. So, now that this front section is done, It's good to convert these lines to a single polyline, and I can do it very easy with the command join. I will activate the command join by typing J. I select all the lines, I press enter, and now I have a polyline here. As easy as you see. The next thing is to put this object to the roof plan. I type CO to copy. I select the object. Press enter. I choose this extremity to my base point. Then I go to the plan, which is this one that is flat here. But to have a better perception, I'm going to hold the button switch plus the mouse wheel. And while moving the mouse, I can turn around my workspace. Then I can just click to place it in this corner here when the endpoint shows there. I press ESC to exit the command. After doing this, I need to extrude this area to the other side of the plan. And a good tool to do this is the command press pull. If I go to the panel home, I can find it right there. So I can click. Now I have to select the area I want to extrude. I click only when it's highlighted. This is important. And now I can extrude where I want. So I'm going to choose this endpoint as I want a roof until this line here. Then it's done. But as you see, it's not completed. It remains this part there that is going to be a smaller section of the roof. The procedure is the same. This time, to view this side in 2D, I have to switch the view to right. Here it is. This smaller section, it's like the first one, just the horizontal line is a bit smaller. So I'm going to type L, insert the first line, and this time the value is 3320. Then the small vertical line, which is 50. I press escape. And then the same in the other side. I click there. And here it is. Right next, I continue with the diagonal line. Don't forget that to insert the angle, I have to press tab. Insert 40. I press escape and I continue in the other side. Press enter to reactivate the previous command. Click on this endpoint. I hit the button tab now and insert 140. As you see, the first line that I draw is not long enough to intersect the second one. But don't worry, because there is a very easy step. I can activate the command extend. I select first the reference line for the extension. I press enter and only after I select the line that I want to extend. This is very important, because if you invert the order, the command will not work. Now what is next? Command trim. And do the same as before. Select both lines and press enter, and then the sections I want to delete. The next step, like before, convert these lines to a polyline. I activate join, select the lines and hit enter. So, now again place this section on the plan. I activate the command copy, typing CO, select the object, click the endpoint in this side to place it exactly in the corner. Now we are almost finishing the roof. Guess that I have to do next? Yes, I will use the command press pull. I select the polyline. And I'm going to extrude it, not till the bottom, but somewhere here in the middle. Just make sure to be completely covered by the main section. I will click in the midpoint, for example. Then, because instead of two sections, I want only one, I will use the perfect tool. It's the command union that you can find it in the section solid editing over there. I click and I select both objects to merge them. Click in the first and yes, this window that opened here is because I have the selection cycling, which is this icon on the button, turned on. And the window appeared because I have objects overlapped. So just click in 3D solid and then select the other 3D solid. Press enter. And suddenly I merged both objects. As you see, the roof is done. Just need to place it above the other part of the house. So I've changed the view to top. I activate the command copy. Select the roof. Click in the base point. And the right button corner that I picked is located at these distances from the corner of the wall. If I use the help of the grid and have the snap mode switched on, I know that is exactly this point. Then I press escape. And if I move the drawing around, I can see that the roof is not located at its correct place. But don't worry, because I only need to bring it up 2600 mm, the height of the exterior walls. And to do this step easier, I can first switch off the layers that I don't need. I activate the command move. And I can easily select only the roof. I press enter. I click there for the base point. And when the polar mode tracks this line vertically, I type 2600 and the roof will be finally in its correct position. Now if I switch on the layers again, you are able to see it done. I can switch to the X-ray or to another viewing mode and you can see the 3D objects in different ways. So, it's all in this part. Thank you very much for watching this video and don't forget to subscribe to CAD in Black to get access to the full list of tutorials. And if you are a beginner and need extra help, I remember you that I start providing online private lessons by Google Hangouts or Skype. If you are interested, just send me an email and I will provide you all the information that you need. Thank you and hope to see you next time.